Hello friends, welcome to another episode of Biomedical Vlogs. Today I am sharing my experience running biomedical job portal since 2017. I am glad that we have more than 25,000 followers in our LinkedIn page, and I would like to thank all biomedical engineers and recruiters, those who supported me. I started this channel Biomedical Vlogs very recently. If you haven't subscribed this channel yet, please do subscribe now. In this video, we will be discussing about the most common mistakes that candidates are doing while applying for a job. I have seen people are telling that I have applied for so many jobs. Unfortunately, I am not getting any response from the recruiter. If you are a recruiter and watching this video, it's my kind request. Try to reply as much possible. Maybe even a single reply would be enough. Like, you are rejected because of this particular reason, so it will help the candidate to prepare better next time. Getting a good job in a company or a hospital is dream for every biomedical engineer, right? So we will look into the different factors that we should consider or we should look seriously while applying for a job. The first point is using the same resume for multiple job applications. It is a common tendency of the people sending the same resume for all the job openings irrespective of the job profile. So make sure you are updating your resume or modifying each time based on the job requirement. The second point is using lengthy resumes. It is very important to keep your resume short as possible because the recruiters won't spend much time on each resume. Personal details like age, marital status, hobbies, this kind of information is not giving any weightage to the resume other than consuming some extra space. The next point is ignoring the key skills and requirements. Understanding the recruiter requirement is very important. Try to avoid being too generalized while preparing your resume. Always focus on the key skill set required for that particular job role. Of course, that would be the most interesting part for the recruiter as well while shortlisting the resumes. If you are an experienced person, focus on specific result of your work or significant achievements or recognition you received. The next point is not including a proper cover letter or mail. We used to say, first impression is the best impression, right? A cover letter is the first chance to stand out from other candidates. It is an opportunity to grab the attention of recruiters and to increase the chance of getting shortlisted. I have seen people sending resume even without a subject line, so try to avoid such mistakes as well. The next point is misspellings and grammatical errors. Double check every word in your resume before applying for a job. Make sure there is no typing or grammatical errors. Even a single error may make a negative impact. Finally, using unreadable or fancy fonts. The fonts you are choosing has a great impact on the readability of your resume. So make sure you are using the fonts which are very easy to read. That's for today, guys. Thank you for watching my video. Bye.